What is going on? Welcome to the channel. My name is Jack and today I'm gonna be breaking down the track Take It On with Vondu, which got released on Subsidia. And yeah, first of all, let's talk a little bit of how this track came together and yeah, how we worked, which person did which part and how we worked on the collab together. And then I'm gonna break down some sounds of the track going from the intro over to the drops. And yeah, first of all, let's excuse, this track is like a real mess because basically I combined both projects. Vondu sent me the project back and I just couldn't work on his template, and so I dragged basically all the parts into my template, and now it's basically a hybrid out of both these projects, and it's a real mess. It's over 200 tracks, and yeah, I even had to freeze some stuff to just record this video, and yeah, sorry about that in the first place. Yeah, if you haven't checked the track out, please make sure to check it out on Spotify, add it to your playlist, and please let me know in the comments below what you think about this track, how you think this collab came together. And yeah, if you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments, leave a like, leave a subscribe, and this way the channel can grow as quickly as possible. And yeah, let's get into it. First of all, I'm gonna play a little part of the track, how it sounds finished. And yeah, like I said, please check out the full track on Spotify or wherever you like to listen. And yeah, let's play it from the intro. Let's play it from the build into the drop. We will go over the intro nonetheless. So this is the build and the first drop here. Let's go. Yeah, this is the first part, the first drop. I think I can't play you the second drop because somehow my PC is freaking out with this. Let's try it though. Ouch, RIP CPU. I have no idea why this happens, but yeah, I try to fix it when we break this down. First of all, I want to talk a little bit of how this track came together. So Vondu and I wanted to do a collab for a while, and yeah, I came up with an idea which sounded completely different. I'm gonna play it to you right now because luckily I still have it. So this is what it sounded originally. Yeah, so it doesn't really flow really good, and the build-up is just a filler, and it was just an idea with a little bit of sound design, and I just threw together an idea quickly. And yeah, Vondu really took it to the next level. He did basically the drop, which is now the second drop here, which I couldn't play you. Let me play it in the original file. I still have it here. So Yeah, so he really, really killed it. Like, it sounds like a complete different track. And actually, I think I sent him the version first where I already did the intro. And the drop even sounded different. I think I have it still here somewhere. But yeah, nonetheless, he flipped the tune into a totally different direction. And I really, really loved the drop. This drop originally was the first drop. And in the end, we switched it because the now the first drop was just a bit more energetic. And we wanted it to have this impact when we... when you first listen to it. And yeah, this is how the track came together. And yeah, let's go into the DAW and break it down for you guys. We're gonna start with the intro. The intro consists of, I say, like three main parts. It's the vocal chop and the both melodies and maybe the wheeze bass, like these are the most important things. And then the drums come in the second part, in the second eight bars here, or the third if you see this as the as a part of the intro too. I'm just gonna play you real quick what we have here, and then we're gonna break it down. Yeah, that's the intro, and yeah, let's break it down. So it starts with this little up thing. And it just has a lot of ambience because it has a reverb on it, a vintage reverb on 100% wet, and I bandpassed it, so originally it sounds like this. And yeah, with a reverb. And then it just had like way too much high end and all that stuff. So I cut it down with a band pass to give some more space for the vocals. It shouldn't be like too upfront. And yeah, this is what the patch looks like. Actually, I have no idea what I made this out of originally. I think it's some kind of string one hit imported in here as a wavetable. So this is what it sounds like without any processing. Let me get rid of this all. And this is just the imported sample here. I think it's some kind of string. So yeah, I don't really know that anymore. And here, just lay it with a bunch of detuning here. Then I put the low pass filter on here, which is modulated by the envelope one cutoff here, just to give it a more plucky sound. And yeah, then I did some processing, just made it a little bit wider with the dimension here, cut out a bit of the low end, and already give it some space with a reverb and a delay, and then bring everything up with the multiband here. Yeah, and then with this processing here, we have this little bad boy. Also, here is a little bit of wind. I think that's something I even recorded. Let me see. I think this is from my Bali vacation. I just recorded some sounds there. Show in browser. Yeah. This is a real nice Bali wind sound here. Other than that, there is just a little bit of ambience going on, vocal ambience here. Same processing, just a little bit of redux, a little bit of reverb, and a panner on there that gives the movement. It's an auto pan with a relatively low weight here. And yeah, it's playing the whole intro basically. And just gives a really, really nice feel. You can just hear barely, but it really fills out the whole spectrum. Yeah, other than that, there is this counter melody going on here, so we have that. And yeah, this patch is just ridiculous simple. I'm gonna just freeze the ARP again, so we don't have a lot of stuff going on here. Let me unfreeze the counter melody, and yeah, it's really, really simple. It's just a sine wave. It's literally just a sine wave, and which gives it that nice glide is the portamento down here, because there are two notes sliding into each other. And it's really just that and a little bit of echo. Other than that, it would sound really, really dry. And I wanted it to have kind of a similar space as the other one. And yeah, together they sound really, really nice. Let me freeze that again. Arch. Yeah, that's that. Other than that, there's just a wheeze going on. Excuse me, my CPU is killing it again. Yeah, the wheeze is really, really simple. It's just a detuned saw wave, which is low cut, and a little bit of compression here going on. Not even a multiband, just to give it some more gain, and yeah, make it more compressed. And which is kind of interesting is that I have a clean sub going out here. Goddamn, why is it clipping again? Yeah, it's that, and then I have a ProQ going on here, which is just cutting out all the side information on the low end, so we don't have much phasing going on. And yeah, that's the whole wheeze patch here. I have a little bit of filtering and washout going on in this part over here in the break section. So where it's going like... Yeah, this is just that. Let me freeze that again. I'm just gonna, yeah, press the back button. Yeah, that's it. And again, really, really sorry about the whole mess here. It's just a really, really messy project. But yeah, we try to navigate through this. Other than that, we have a clock ticking going on, some more ambient sounds, and yeah, just some impacts and stuff. This is an impact from an upcoming sample pack. I hope it comes out really, really soon. I will let you guys know about that. And yeah, other than that, the main part here really is the vocal. And I think that's the reason why my CPU is kind of clipping out, because there's kind of a lot of processing going on here. Originally, this is an a cappella, which doesn't sound anywhere like this. I'm just gonna Euphoria a cappella. It's Cymatics one, which sounded originally like that. Tell me, babe, you wanna leave this town? I'm saying, love it if you want. Which is kind of funny because it doesn't sound like that at all. This is what the vocal shop sounds like now. And I'm really, really sorry that it's clipping that hard. Like I said, there's a bunch of processing on here. I'm just gonna turn off all the processing so you can hear what it sounds like without anything. It sounds like this. And yeah, I use the Simpler for this, Ableton Simpler. It has the slice mode where you can play a little bit with the modes here. I use the transient mode and the sensitivity just to... this basically controls where it cuts. And yeah, I just found the sweet spot here at 77%. Also, I turned up the whole vocal by 9 semitones, because originally the a cappella was in F sharp minor and our track is in D sharp minor. So yeah, it's 9 semitones up. or three semitones down, but yeah, I wanted it to have that higher sound. Next up, I've put a little altar boy on there, which is just giving it some format correction down. Yeah, other than that, I have a little vocal rack going on here. I think this is the one from the Andrew Huang. I don't know if I pronounced that right. It's really hard for me. I'm from Germany, if you haven't recognized already. So bear with me if my English is really, really bad. I try to do my best here. Yeah, this is just a little whack, which gives it that really, really nice ambience sound. I will try to link you the video if I find it in here. Shout out to him. And I think it's Reed Stefan too. It's originally like the whack from him. Yeah, then I did a little bit of low cut here, boosted the vocal a bunch to make it even louder. And then I did a little bit of more reverb. This is a sidechained Valhalla Super Massive, which is really, really cool. It's a I think it's even free. And yeah, it's a combination out of a reverb and a delay, and it's really, really cool. I use it a bunch of times on vocals. These are the settings. I think it's even a preset in here. I'm just gonna freeze the vocals real quick. I'm gonna fast forward and then gonna show you the rest of the processing on the whole group. Before I do that, let me show you how I came up with that pattern. So basically, I just played like with different notes on the keyboard, which sounded cool. So that's the cool part about that slice thing from the Ableton Simpler. You can just put anything in there and chop it up and play it with your keyboard. And yeah, this is just how it came up with that little thing here. So let's go back to the freezing. Oh god, we finally made it. So yeah, I'm gonna show you the rest of the processing. I have a Isotope Trash 2 on here, which I think is just boosting the top end a little bit. Let me see. Yeah, I just have a little bit of top end curve on here just to give it some more harshness. Yeah, this just makes it a lot brighter. Then I have a mid-side soothe rack on here, which I don't really use anymore, but it's just a soothe in parallel, one on the mids, one on the sides. Just to get rid of some of the resonances here. Then I have a low cut here, just to get rid of any low informations at 180. Then another Pro Q, just to smooth out some more of the top end here. And then I have a Pro L on here. I don't really know why. Just to make it louder, I think, which is even automated somehow. No, it's not. Yeah, I don't know. I just made it a bit louder. And then we have that little curve going on here. I don't really know where the filter comes in. Let me see. Yeah, it's just for the outro here. Yeah, just for the outro. And that's it with the vocal. And I think that's all the like important part. Then we just have some more effects here, impacts going on and all that. Let's talk about the drums, which are kind of cool too. Oh, something sounds wrong now. Let me see, the vocal is way too quiet. Yeah, I turned off the Pro L. Yeah, the drums. Which do we have here? So, the intro drums. Yeah, right here we just have some simple stuff going on for transitional things. Mostly cashmere stuff. Yeah, it's all cashmere stuff. It's really, really good. I love to use it. Other than that, we have a remedy kick going on here. We have a decap snare. and a Remedy snare, which kind of gives it that nice pattern. And with this little fill thing, I pan the drums a little bit. So left, right, and they are quieter. They are turned down like 70 dB than the original. And yeah, that's it for this. Other than that, there's this breakbeat loop from the ModStep splice pack. Yeah, which I think I've put it to beats mode to the unipolar thing and turned it down so it's a lot sharper. Originally it sounded like that, which was kind of weird because it was pitched down that much. And yeah, I just put it to 42 and it sounded a lot cleaner that way. Yeah, other than that, we have a white going on from the Leviathan pack. Altogether, it sounds like this. Then I have some drum loops going on. One is from my pack. And I think these are even, yeah, OTT'd, and they have a little bit of sidechain going on and all that stuff, and a little bit of reverb. Another perk loop. Yeah, and it's all pretty heavily sidechained to the kick. Yeah, and it just together gives this nice groove, and with the whole drums together, it sounds like this. And I think I've put a little bit of drum bass on the whole group and OTT just to even it out. And the intro drums, whole intro group is, I think it's sidechained somewhere. Maybe it's not. Yeah, I think I have it on my sidechain group here. Yeah, I have a little bit of the Live 8 compressor on the kick here. Yeah, and this is what it sounds like. I have no idea why this is even turned off. I think it shouldn't be supposed to be turned off. Yeah. Yeah, this is my sidechain. I use Chain Shaper for sidechaining. I can't recommend this plugin enough. It's really, really simple. You set your inputs up. And I talk about this plugin a lot in my other videos and streams. So yeah, I'm gonna try to link you a video about it if I already made it. If not, there will definitely come a video about my sidechaining. I don't want to go too technical about this. Yeah, then we go into the build-up here, which are mostly just build-up stuff from my sample pack and some claps and a little snare. Other than that, there is another snare going on. These drum things are looping, so everything is just building. We have a little bit of the original drop sounds going on here. Just pitched up. And I think, yeah, there's a little bit of introduction from the drop synth. And I think sub-wise, yeah, we have this little thing going on here, which I have no idea what it was originally. I think it was some kind of wheeze we sampled, and then the wheeze is just building up like 12 semitones going up and filtering up here. And yeah, this is basically it, I think. Yeah, we have a brass going on here. Yeah, which is just two different brass samples, one panned a little bit right, one a little bit left, and also track delay to give them some more width. And yeah, other than that, just a lot of risers and the vocal we sampled here somewhere. Yeah, it's this here. We sampled it just to cut off some of the transients and to fade it a little bit. And yeah, it's rising with a little bit of frequency shifting and filtering and all that. I think on the master, there's also Endless Smile somewhere, which we don't seem to use here though. Yeah, I don't know, we don't seem to use it here. Yeah, let's go into the drop, the most interesting part. So the first drop, like I said, was originally the second drop, and we made it a really, really, in a really, really weird way. I resampled the whole first drop and played around with it in Edison. I don't know if you know this plugin Edison. It's originally a Fruity Loops recorder. And yeah, it's a pretty weird way to get this sounds. First of all, let's start with the drop basses here. So these are just from some sound design sessions I did. Let me see if I can find those. Show in browser. How's it called? Thick Boy. Yeah, it's just some random sound design sessions I did. I will post some sound design videos here too. This is like how I work most of the times. Like I have all these sound design sessions, I make some different basses and all that, and I'm just using them for later use. Yeah. If you guys are interested in this, just let me know in the comments below, and I will be doing some sound design videos because I fucking love sound designing. And yeah, like I said, I resampled the whole thing in Edison. I don't think I have it anymore. But yeah, basically I recorded it into there, and I can try to drag this out and unloop it and see how it sounds like that. Yeah, basically it's just let me show it to you. I'm gonna open a new instance of Edison. Yeah, and you can record some stuff in here, basically anything. I used that little scratch thing here. I think I saw that in a Nasco video originally. Let me actually bump this on this track here. And yeah, it's a really, really weird way to get a new thing out of a already existing thing. So I just recorded the first drop basically. And then I just played around. I put another Edison behind it to record it, and then I played around with that. Yeah, and you can get some really, really crazy sounds, and I just imported that and played with it till I got something really, really cool. And actually, Wandu and I were in a Zoom session while doing that, and we did a lot of trial and error, and we couldn't get like a cool second drop going on. And somewhere it came around to that sound here, which is pretty cool, and it is layered with that little laser thing here. And yeah, before you say anything, my master is clipping like hell, and that's like what I do like most of the times. So it's really, really clipping here. You can see it's 11 dB clipping, but it sounds fine. Like that's the version that is out now, and yeah, that's the way I work. Sometimes I have a clipper on the master, but I think it wasn't in this project. Yeah, for the actual sub, I have just this little recording. I recorded a lot of sustained sub noises in different keys. So I have all this going on here. These are just like clean sub noises. Sometimes I like to work just with audio, and this was the case in here. You can really fade it and play with the phasing and all that. And yeah, that's this here. Yeah, that's the original sub. We just boosted some of the harmonics here. And this part here is just Isotope Trash 2. I really, really recommend it to you. I think it's on sale again on Plugin Boutique. They have sales with that all the time. You can get it for $10 or so. And it's like, seriously, it's like one of the best distortion plugins I ever came around. And I use it for my subs all the time. I think I made a video already on it. I don't know if it's up at this point, but I will definitely do a video about doing subs and 808s and all that. Yeah, it's just a preset I used here. I've put a gate behind it because otherwise you get these weird tails here. And then just EQ'd it till it sounded good. And there's an imager on here just to give it some boost in the some width boost in the top end. Yeah, and that's that. That's the layer, and together it sounds like that. Really fat. Yeah. And it's being pitched by an elastic pitch on the whole group. And some EQing here. And yeah, that's basically the first drop. I'm gonna go over the drums real quick. Yeah, it's a stem kick right now because, like I said, I imported like a bunch of stuff from the other project. And I have no idea what the original kick was. I think it was a kick out of my pack. Yeah, I wish I could say a little bit more than that, but yeah, this project is a whole mess. So I'm really, really sorry about that. Yeah, other than that, we have that little wheeze going on here. Let me find it. And I think that's even a Wii sample too. Yeah, it's a Wii sample from one of my sound design sessions too. Really sorry. Yeah, that's... Yeah, that's... I'm sorry about that, but that's usually how I work. Like, I sound design and then use it in my projects. But if you want to see how to make such a Wii, just let me know and I'll make a video about that. And yeah, then it's just playing around with different sounds. And what you see me do a lot is just reverb throws, just automating the mix of the reverb. And yeah, that is that. For this part, I kind of switched up the pattern a bit. I played around with different things from the Wii sample here. Also, I have a Serum Effects going on here and an LFO tool. I think this is a reverb filter. Yeah, it's a reverb filter, and after it, it's an LFO tool just to shape it again. Let me deactivate that. Because that is really, really messy, right? And with the LFO tool, it just brings it back to shape. Yeah, other than that, some EQing, some reverb to give it some room. And I think this is just for the transition into the break here. Yeah, that's that sound. Let's go. Yeah, same here. I think there's the Endless Smile now doing the job. No, it's not the Endless Smile. Maybe it's something on here. Yeah, it's a washout on the sidechain group. Yeah, this part is just another part of that, but just more chopped up and more repeated. And playing around a little bit with the frequency shifter here. Which sounds kind of cool. Other than that, we have a bunch of background elements here. I think Vondu did most of them. I think these sirens and stuff are originally from me, and he did a lot of the vocal chops and... I I think this is resampled from the intro. And yeah, then the last part of the drop is there. Yeah, I think it's the same thing I showed you before with the LFO tool, but just on a higher weight. Yeah, it's 132 triplets, which is really giving it that dragon feel and really sharp transient feel. And here it's just, I think this is just pitched up, a pitched up version of that. Yeah, and that's basically it. On the break part here, there's just another thing coming in here. Which is another serum patch. It's just, I think something really simple again. Yeah, it's just a pretty simple plug thing again, with a bunch of processing, vintage up again to give it some room. And yeah, a cool MIDI pattern here, just to give it some switch up so it doesn't sound like all the same. Just copy and paste, you know. And we have that little bass guitar coming in too, which is... Yeah, it's I think it's Substance for both. It's an output plugin. I think it's just some preset, two presets layered here. Yeah, it's a string E bass here, which is really cool. Which gives this, and this is just another preset here. You get the idea. And yeah, then the second drop is basically, I think Vondo take like most of the sounds I've made and just frequency shift them and made them into a much more simple pattern here. So we have that. I'm sorry, my CPU is kind of clipping here again. Yeah, so he took a sound I made originally, and which I think you can recognize, it kind of sounds the same like the first idea I showed you. And yeah, he just pitched it. And yeah, played around with some different patterns here. And this is just, I think it's just a pitch automation here, transposition, yeah, which is going down, which gives it this slowdown feeling. And yeah, other than that, he layered it with another shot. So this is below the whole thing, which is giving it this nice syncopation. And Rondo works a lot with like this layering, like he has one main sound that's playing underneath and yeah, just doing some other rhythms on top of other stuff. I really, really love his stuff like a lot. He has some really, really cool grooves. And yeah, that's basically it, other than that. Yeah, other than that, my CPU can't really handle this fire drop here. So yeah, if you have any questions, just let me know. Please, please, please make sure again to subscribe, to leave a comment. Let me know what you think about that track. Let me know what you think about the quality of the video, because this is like one of the first videos I ever did. And I plan to put out 3 videos each week, which is kind of a high goal, because I have no idea if that is even possible for me right now. But yeah, I want to try to make as much content for you guys as possible. So please, please support me. Also, I will be live streaming probably once a week. I try every Sunday. It doesn't work out all the time, but I'll let you guys know on my socials. And yeah, the next video is coming up really, really soon. And thank you for joining me on this journey. And this year is really taking off already. I have the release, my EP release with Hybrid Trap going on. I have the Subsidio release, and I have a bunch of tracks like in the back, and searching just a home for them. And yeah, really, really excited for what comes. And I want to take you guys on a journey with me. And yeah, I'm really, really glad for all the support from you. And yeah. See you next time, brothers and sisters. Shit, where is it?